You are welcome this morning, the 14th of February 2021, to Regina, Saskatchewan, Canada. This is a glorious day. For the past 1 week, we've been facing extreme cold, which has not been recorded in recent times. It's been minus 25 to minus 30 for almost the whole of the week. And there was a day with the wind chill or a few days when the temperature was over minus 50. Records were broken all over the country. And there was a time the whole of the country was cold from coast to coast. Isn't that strange? That makes me ponder about strangers in a strange land. Strangers in a strange land. That is the focus of what I want us to look at this morning. But before we do that, I want us to go to the Lord in prayer. Everlasting Father, King of glory, we thank you. King of glory, we exalt you. King of glory, we thank you because of your goodness and because of your mercy. We thank you, Lord, because it's the goodness of the Lord that has kept each and every one of us. For the Bible says, by grace we are saved, and it is not of our own works. We thank you, Lord, for your grace that is our sufficiency. Lord, we honor you. King of glory, we thank you, Lord, because we are strangers in this world. This world is not our home. We are just passing through. Lord, just give us the grace to think about our heavenly home. Give us the grace, Lord, to know that life is temporal. Give us the grace to know that there is heaven and there is hell. Give us the grace to know about eternity in our lives. Eternity as a purpose. Eternity as a place that we go and will not come back. Lord, we just pray that this week ahead, as you look at the week ahead, will be a week of glory. It be a week that all the adversaries, the enemies of our lives, Lord, Father, they will be put to shame. And that, Lord, we will have victory and we'll be able to say, yes, of the truth, you are God. Many people trust in chariots and horses, but we will trust in the name of the Lord. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. Father, as you look at the examples of people of old in the Bible who are strangers in the strange land, Lord, help us, Lord, to sharpen our lives. Help us, Lord, to re-examine our lives. Because in this world in which we are, there is no more truth. There is no more truth. Truth has been given another name. They call it alternate truth. Lies is all over the place. Whether in the hospitals, whether in the teaching academic institutions, whether in our day-to-day lives, whether at home, lie is the order of the day. So, Father, we just pray that we, those who are called by your name, those who have not been called, Lord, you will call them to yourself. Because your purpose is that no soul should perish, but that everyone should come to repentance. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy upon whom you want to have mercy, Lord. Lord, have mercy so that your blood on Calvary will not be shed in vain. Yes, I know you are listening to me in a home. You cannot trust that husband. It is so bad. So, Father, I just pray, Lord, that that woman, that individual, Lord, Father, that you will minister to her, Lord. Lord, that you, in your infinite mercy, Lord, we just let her know that you are with her. Lord, encourage her. And Lord, I pray that you touch the life of that man, Lord, who is supposed to know better, but he's not walking in faith and victory with you, Lord. Everlasting Father, I know you are listening to me. You are so discouraged about the things of God, about congregation, about churches, because of so many things you hear, because of so many things that have happened. So, Lord, I just pray that you will remind each and every one of us to know that we do not rely on men, We do not rely on any human being, but rely upon you, because you are the only one that is unfailing. Lord, just open our eyes of understanding. Open the eyes of understanding of our ministers, the pastors, the GOs, the directors, the Pentecostal leaders, non-Pentecostal leaders, charismatic leaders, Lord, that we know that one day we give account to you. Lord, we just honor you. We give you the adoration. We give you the honor. Thank you, Lord, for hearing us. For we have prayed in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. I thank God this morning for this lovely day. You see, why do I say lovely day? Any day that the Lord has made is a beautiful day. This morning, we are going to look at the topic entitled Strangers in a Strange Land. Strangers in a Strange Land. The two aspects that are involved, they are one, stranger, and two, the land. We are all sojourners on this side of eternity. Many of us don't realize that. Many of us think this is the final place. And I want to reassure you, I want to tell you, as you all know, as most of you know, but you don't come to realization that you are strangers in this world. There is this popular song we used to sing. This world is not my home. I am just passing through. If heaven is not my home, oh Lord, what shall I do? There are angels before me, and heaven open door, and I cannot feel at home in this world anymore. When you look at this world in which we are strangers. But the unfortunate thing is that people live as if everything ends here, including ministers, including non-ministers, including pastors, including so many congregations. We build our castle here. We think this is our home. We build our castle. We think we are going to live to 100, 120 years. And some of us who are in the 60s, some of us who are in the 70s, we think that, X live for 100, you are deceiving yourself, you think you're going to live another 20, 30 years, you might be kidding. Recently, just about a week ago, I lost my uncle, who died at the age of 87. 87, he lived a useful life. He was loving. He did everything humanity can do. He was a top minister, right far back in Nigeria. He did everything. He was quite up to the standard. But I want to tell you, no matter how well we are up to the standard of this world, one day will be called. He is being called. My question to you, my listener, is this. Do you ever think of the day, the time that will be called? You will be called. I will be called. Because the Bible says it is appointed unto man once to die, after death, the judgment. When you look at different countries, we have our immigration rules, we have our passport. I want to ask you, just as I asked some of our listeners before, do you have a passport to heaven? Passport to heaven is the only universal passport. In this life, every country has its own passport. Every country, but there are some territories now, the European Union, Britain is now out of the European Union, and you realize West African countries, African countries, they are trying to get an ECOWAS, Economic Community of West African Communities. There are so many things people are doing to for that sense of belonging. But I want to tell you, the only universal passport that you and I can have that will make us enter to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords' presence, that is heaven, is to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. The Bible says there is a way that seemeth right unto man, the end thereof is destruction. Jesus Christ himself says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He said, nobody comes to the Father except through me. That man never lied. Everything he said was true. I want to ask you, have you ever felt out of place? As if you don't fit in and would rather be at home? Yeah, I felt like that at times. My wife has felt like that at times. I remember in 1989, when we were in Leicester in England, I was taking my five-year-old son home that afternoon, and I looked at him at the back, and he was crying. And I said, well, Toby, why are you crying? He said, because nobody played with me at school today. I said, why? I said, why? Can you imagine a five-year-old? He said, because I'm black. What I'm saying is that it hurt me so deeply. And I said, Lord, I felt like just packing my luggage and go back to my country, Nigeria, because I thought that is my home. But that is not my home. I'm a stranger. One day I'll be a stranger in Nigeria. You are here in Canada. When I ask some of you, you say, oh, I'm Canadian, because my generations, fourth generation, fifth generations, yes, they came from somewhere and they are here. You are settled here. You think this is your home. This is not your home. You are a stranger. This world is not a home. We are strangers in a strange land. And if you don't fit in, and would rather be at home, I pray that heaven will be in your mind. That this morning, as you listen to this message, you say, where am I going? Where is heaven? Where is the purpose and plan of God in my life? There are some, the only thing they think about is this life, this life. How am I going to make my next $100,000? How am I going to make my next $500,000? There are some pastors, they use all kinds of imaginations, all kinds of psychology to expand their churches. The reason being, they want tithes, they want offerings. And this is the world in which we are. And the people feel, what do you feel? What do you feel? There's how many people that when they step into a local church, they don't feel welcome. They are strangers. I want you to know that if you are a minister, God has given you a ministry. You need to make your people feel at home because you are a stranger in this land. We're going to look at the book of Genesis, the book of beginning. We're going to look at the story of Abraham. The Bible says Abraham is called by God to leave his country and emigrate to a new land. We read that in Genesis 12, 10, and what happened. So he packs his camels and heads out west and set up housekeeping as a resident alien. And he is not alone. He went with his cousin, Lot. And what happens is that when you are in a strange land, certain things do happen. There was some misunderstanding between Abraham and Lot, and they parted their ways. But because God blessed Abraham, he listened to the voice of the Lord. God bless him. Abraham was not alone. The path of Joseph's story were all shaped by migration. That's the problem with many of us. We think that, oh, this is my own country. We are going to oppress this individual. I want you to know that this is not your home. Because God prospered Joseph despite being in a strange land. Look at all the plots by the enemies of his souls. Strangers and pilgrims, we are in this passing age. Strangers are pilgrims because we are all like the patriarchs of old, characterized by nomadic existence while awaiting the promised land. Just look at what's been going on for almost 1.5 years now, the pandemic of COVID-19. Look at how many people die on a daily basis worldwide. Look at how many people are going to die today. The statistics is just like as if you are killing flies or cockroaches are dying. Because I cannot even imagine that in my lifetime, as a medical doctor, we will have so many people dying despite our technology. We do not know what to do. Research upon research is going on. As we are trying to attack COVID-19, another variant is rising. We have the variant Brazilian we have the UK variant, we have the Nigerian variant, we have all of them. Because God is telling us that I'm in control. God is telling us that we are in straight line. This is not your home. This is not my home. We are just passing through. God's coming kingdom will bring heaven to earth. And what is going to happen is that He will tear down the institutions of our exile. This institution will be torn down. Institution of racial prejudice will be torn down. Institution of insubordination will be torn down. Institution of sexual immorality will be torn down. Institution of pornography will be torn down. Institution where there's deceit, there's lying everywhere will be torn down. And replacement of them with a new home in the holy city. Holy city where we will dwell with Him forever. The book of Revelation says it in Revelation 21 to 22. The vision that was revealed unto John. And I want you to know that if you are living your life as if all ends here, you are making a mistake. If you live your life as if everything ends here, all do not end there. Because where we are strangers. Caring for strangers, God's people often are sojourners. So we are also being encouraged. We are also called to care for strangers in our midst. I see how many Christians, communities, how many churches. I was going to one church one time. There was a kind of misunderstanding in the church. And the minister said, this church has a revolving door. If you don't like it, walk out. He was castigated by the elders and those people in that congregation, but that was coming from the pastor who was supposed to be leading the church. People don't remember that they are strangers. When Israel was given the law at Mount Sinai, foreigners received special attention and legal protection. You looked at in Exodus 22:21. This is why if you are a child of God, you think this is your home, Regina is your home, Saskatchewan is your home, Canada is your home, you are oppressing strangers, you better think twice. Because it is unbiblical. The kind of discrimination that we even talk in the household of God should not be mentioned. This was important because immigrants lack extended family. And both of, and social networks. The social networks we have in our society, some people they use it to the detriment of others. When something happens at work, instead of them dealing with this in a straight manner, they deal with it in a crooked manner. They deal with this in a crooked manner. And when you look at extended family and social network, they are very significant for survival in the ancient world, in this world in which we are. Christ has welcomed us into His home. The Father says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. One of the reasons for God calling us, He knows that this world is not our home. We are just passing through. God reminded His people that they were once slaves themselves in Egypt. And do not mistreat or oppress a foreigner, for you are foreigners in a strange land, in a foreign land, in Egypt. You look at Exodus 22, verse 21, you will see Israel was not to repeat Egypt's mistakes. The mistake they made in Egypt, the Egyptians, was that they differentiate between foreigners, between strangers, and the owners of the land, the inhabitants of the land. So what happened was that they were using them as slaves. They made them work from morning to night, no break. The wages was poor. They were living under extreme bad condition. And the same thing is happening where we are today. The same thing is happening in Western world. The same thing is happening in Africa. Because when you think it doesn't happen, it's only happening in the Western world, you are kidding yourself. We have some nationalities that are in Nigeria. And what happens is that they are employed at the cheapest rate. They are used as slave labor. It happens in England. It happens in Canada where we are. We are here. We have people that come on a seasonal basis, they come and do work for us. They don't, some of them don't have their health care in the system. Some of them, they work from morning to night, what Canadians cannot do. In Africa, we have, in Nigeria, when I was growing up, we have people we call house help. Some of them come from neighboring countries like Togo, like Ghana, and they do chores at home that our own kids cannot do. It is not just the problem of the white race, it's the problem of human race. This was like leaving the edges of your home for poor people to come up with. And I want you to know that one thing that you need to do is to remember that you're a stranger. Christ has welcomed you into his family. That is why you and I, whether you are white, whether you are Burgundy, whether you are green, whether you are black, whatever color you call yourself, when you go to the household of God, you have that authority. You have that power. You have that privilege to go into the presence of King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. It doesn't have to be a white man or a black person or Asian person to pray for you or to assist you. The author of Hebrews reminds us, do not be conformed to this world. Do not forget to show hospitality to strangers. Do not be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind. I want you to think about it this morning, if you've never thought about that, that you are strangers in this world. Where we were living before, we have our next door neighbor. Oh, lovely guy. The kind of hospitality that he has on is just immense in Wascana Highland. I even give him a name, I call him Angel on our street. He will do everything you can. He will help us with our garbage trash. He will help us even at times, not only us, he will help other people around to move their dustbin, to move everything. Oh, what a man. Every Christmas, my wife always remember, oh, we need to buy a gift for this individual at Christmas. We call him Bob. What a great man. He's Caucasian, but he has the love of God. What made him transform his life is because he has learned the grace of God and is a child of God. It's not a question of color. It's a question of who you are. It's a question of what you want to be. It's a question of having heaven open in your mind. Jesus practiced what he preached. And we see that clearly in the scriptures. He says this scripture is birth is a sign of the promised Messiah King whose rule abides for all nations. Matthew 2:1-12, Isaiah 63. You see how his birth was predicted, that a Messiah would be born. And the kingdom will be upon his shoulder. He will become wonderful, Emmanuel, the savior of the whole world. I want you to know that through Jesus' birth, you and I, we have that joy, we have that peace. And if you are a child of God, if you don't think that you are strangers in this world, you are missing the whole essence of death and resurrection. There are so many of our GOs, general overseers, so many of founders of this congregation, many congregations there and there, what they do is they build eternity in this world. They build eternity in this world. And I pray that this message, as it is being heard by thousands of people all over the world, that people will know that this is not our home. We are all strangers. They build eternity here. They build mansions. Many of them, some of them, they have two, three private jets. When if you only sell one private jet, you can imagine the millions of people that you will be feeding. You can imagine how heaven will open, that can open the door of salvation to many people, because they see Christ in you. They say, because when you look at Christ during his lifetime, the people were troubling him. They were looking for miracles. They were in need. People often forget that by doing that, you can bring somebody who has not known the Lord and Savior into the fold of the kingdom. It's not just by preaching. If you don't preach with your life, you are making a big mistake. In the area where we were living before, I remember my dentist who was not a Christian. But through the hospitality, through what he sees, we try to minister to him. And he said, listen, the Lord has touched my life and I'm so glad for him. He was giving testimonies and testimonies upon everything. This is a white individual. This is a Caucasian. He came to me, he hugged me, he was crying. I want you to know that the only thing you can show, people call it hospitality, people call it kindness, you can call it any name, is to know that you are a stranger in this land. And because you are a stranger, you need to leave a legacy. I don't know what legacy you want to leave. My uncle is going to be buried on the 23rd of February, far back in Nigeria. But one legacy that man left, legacy of love. I'm not saying whether he's a Christian or that. I'm not the one that is going to judge him and we are going to celebrate his life. But what I'm saying that he showed that love. Where is the love of Christ in your heart? Because if you know that this is not your home, you and I, we will reach out. Because this is a strange land, I'm going to conclude the latter part of this podcast about the strange land. Why is this land so strange? We talk of flu pandemic. We know of millions of people that died. We're not talking of COVID-19. And we say it originated from Wuhan, China. We are not talking of another strain from Britain that is so deadly. We are talking of Brazilian strain, South African strain. We are talking of Nigerian strain. I want you to know that this land is strange. Why is it strange? You and I, we work hard, we achieve wealth in life, and some suddenly they leave it, some they have chronic illness. And chronic illness until they die. And everything that they have labored for, they will leave it. That's why the book of Proverbs says vanity upon vanity. The Savior's death broke the dividing that keep Gentiles separate from those who are believers. And now through the power of Christ's resurrection, Jesus welcomes all who will come unto him. You and I, we are strangers. I pray that the Lord will open your eyes to know that this is a strange land. We see what happens in America with all their wealth, with all their power. Yesterday, they were just debating and debating. They have been at it for about 2 weeks now, whether the former President Trump is guilty. Who does not know? You don't have to be a lawyer. That somebody who behaved like that should be found guilty. But the played with the letters. They play with everything. But I want you to know that you and I, one day we stand before the judgment throne of God. God is no respecter of person. God is no respecter of person. They came to the conclusion that they acquitted him. I'm not the judge, but look at people that died through the demonstration. It could happen to the other party also, Democrats, but look at what happened. If the president of the most powerful nation can do that, and it's all because the people are afraid to lose their seats because of the support he still has. But there is one rightful judge. There is one person. There is one person that will all stand before him. Because on the day of judgment, it is not because of your wealth or my wealth, my position. God is no respecter of person. This is a strange land in which we are, and we are all strangers. You can imagine the Bible says, you foolish man, you don't know when your life will be asked of you. So people are scheming. He's scheming for to be re-elected in 4 years. Who knows whether he'll be alive? People go, they have crashes. People have incurable illness. People die, people sleep and they don't wake up. People can have massive attack. There are so many things that can take us away from him. That is why it is strange land. I want you to remember this morning. This world is not your home. This world is not my home. We are just passing through. And everything you and I do, they are being recorded in the book of life. And you can make your decision today to say, yes, Lord, I want to follow you. I want to be obedient to your word. I want you to be my Lord and Savior. Because that is the only thing that can save you and I from the wrath of God. Because whether we like it or not, judgment of God is inevitable. You are strangers in this world. And this is a strange land. We have catastrophes. We have all kinds of problems. We have all sorts of disasters, hunger, famine. Look at war going in Yemen. Look at war going in Eritrea. Look at war going in Kenya. Look at war going in Nigeria, in some parts of the country, and they are now spreading. It's happening all over the world. Where do you want to spend eternity? This is a strange land. Remember, you are a stranger. This is not your home. This world is not your home. You are passing through. Remember, this is not your home. The Lord woke me up this morning and I was meditating since last night. Say, Lord, what do you want me to tell your people? The message is this. This world is not your home. You are just passing through. And for you to enter the home that God has prepared for you, you need to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. You need to accept the plan of salvation on Calvary. I did that 47 years ago, and there is no turning back. By His grace, I have not used any power beside the name of Jesus. I have not used any means. I have put my trust in Him, because the trust that I have in Him is when even the tide is rough, I know that He's there for me. When the going is rough with my children, I know you are there for us. I never look back and say, Lord, I should have gone back. No. I want you to know that there is a way that seems right unto man. The end thereof is destruction. Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Have you been to Jesus for that cleansing power? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Because this is a strange land. The only place that is not strange that you and I will be going is heaven. If you have not accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you are living a wasteful life. I'm sorry to put it blunt. If you have not accepted the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, if the only thing you depend upon is your material possession, is your wealth, is everything, you are making the big mistake. If the only thing that I depend upon, being a physician of 40 years standing, is because of what I have, I'm deceiving myself, because I will leave them one day, because I will leave everything one day. If the only thing you are thinking about is to leave those possessions for your children, where they are going to buy Ferrari, they are going to buy all kinds of this thing and spend it the way they want to spend it, you are making a big mistake. They will also leave it. This world is not your home. I'm pleading with you. This world is, you are a stranger here. No matter how many generations of your people that have lived in Canada, maybe they come from England, Scotland, they come from Ireland or Russia, you say, oh, Canada and Canadian, you are just deceiving yourself. This is not your home. The First Nation, they are the people that supposedly own this place, but this is not their home. This world is not your home. This world is not my home. I am just passing through. And as we pass through, may we pass through to eternity, Lord. Father, we bless you. El Shaddai, we honor you. We thank you, Lord, because we are strangers here. Heaven is our home. Lord, give us the grace, Lord, to look upon you. Give us the grace, Lord, to walk faithfully with you. Give us the grace, Lord, as you called us this morning again, to repent of our sins and make a U-turn back to Calvary, to make a U-turn to the lover of our souls, to make a U-turn and say, Lord, it's you and no other one, to make a U-turn from the wealth and riches of this life that have encroached upon us, Lord, and that we'll be able to live a life of glory. Father, we just bless you. El Shaddai will honor you. We thank you, Lord, for your goodness. As we look at the week ahead, we do not know what it holds, but we can face tomorrow because you live. So, Lord, those who are listening to me this morning, Lord, and those who will be listening to me later on, Father, I just pray, Lord, for the blessings of heaven upon their lives, Lord. Every situation that pertains to them, Lord, Father, have mercy. Because you said, I will have mercy upon whom I want to have mercy. Lord, be ye exalted. Be ye glorified. Thank you, Lord, for hearing us. Thank you, Lord, for your merciful God. Thank you, Lord, because we are strangers here. And one day, you will call us home. Lord, we honor your name. We give you the glory. For we have prayed in Jesus' mighty name.